Hello and welcome to my 6th devlog of Milkman game. I managed to create a destructible milk bottle by slicing it up in Blender, and used particle effects to show milk spilling out of the bottle. In the last update, I converted this rather dreary and simplistic Brackey's tutorial background into a dreamy, sunset-filled scenery with little houses and grass. Although, I saw this horrific comment on Reddit, and ended up crying all day. After I recovered from my fountain of tears, I worked to bring you this devlog, so let's get started. Since a principal part of my game is trying to keep milk bottles on the trailer of the milk truck, obviously I had to create the graphics for a situation where the milk bottles do fall off the truck. I sort of wanted it to be realistic, but I also wanted it to be cartoonish. I didn't want explosive milk bottles, but I did want it to sort of be funny when you did break some. I first focused on the glass milk bottle itself. I knew I had to create a destructible glass bottle. I figured out that you quite obviously needed two objects and so researched how to instantiate destructible object versions upon a triggering event. So in Blender, I studied how to use the knife tool and bisect tool, and well, basically just started chopping away. I couldn't figure out how to use the bisect tool without deleting one portion of the object I was bisecting. So I ended up having to replicate the bisection on both sides of the object, which meant that the cuts weren't exactly lined up, and so when I tried to match up the pieces again, it didn't quite link together seamlessly. I wasn't too bothered by this because it was supposed to be a bunch of broken pieces of the bottle anyway. So I imported it into Unity and resized it, obviously, because milk bottles aren't usually that large. And the next thing was to add colliders onto the individual pieces. I decided to forego the whole mesh collider thing again, and just built a bunch of box colliders onto the individual glass pieces. It didn't have to be that accurate, because it was just a bunch of broken pieces. So, after that was done, I thought the bottle shattering needed a few more broken bits of glass, and as anyone who has broken glass at home would know. I then had a brainwave. Why don't I just create hundreds of tiny white beads to represent the milk, and see if it looks like milk is spilling everywhere? Well, it turns out my brainwave was really just a dumb idea, because a milk liquid effect looked kind of stupid. So I looked everywhere for the right tutorial, and eventually found a blood splatter tutorial by Axa Nadim, who, by the way, does some great tutorials on particle effects, so check her stuff out. Her blood splatter was almost exactly what I was looking for, but I wasn't sure if it would work well in the environment that I had built. I won't bore you with the entire process, but suffice it to say, it produced some pretty interesting results on the way. Essentially, this weird droplet thing was supposed to be the milk splattering out of the bottle in random sizes and directions, but I had to tone it down a fair amount because it just looked weird. I then added the splatter component, which triggers once the first droplet touches a surface. I had a lot of trouble with this, especially trying to make the splatter appear parallel to the ground and not perpendicular, somehow. I experimented what the milk would look like if it hit a wall, and it didn't look great. It also appeared to be occurring parallel to the ground, but in mid-air, so all of a sudden I had weird milk snowflakes in the middle of summer. Even then, the amount of explosiveness of the milk was a bit much. It was like someone dropped some Mentos in Coca-Cola. As you can see here, I played around with loads of different values just to see what they would do. And anyway, I kept working on it so that it would become more of a mild spill. The next thing I worked on was a script for the milk particle effect. I wrote some weird code at first, like new object equals new something, because I thought I was dealing with pure C# functions, but turns out Unity has its own instantiate function. I struggled a little bit at this point to enter the relevant parameters for the instantiation, in particular transform and rotation values. Funnily enough, I also saw how weird the milk looked. It was as if I had created a network of milk webs spurting everywhere. It was also instantiating perpendicular to the ground now, and it just looked bad. So I looked up how to fix my code and played around with quaternion values. I adjusted the rotation of one of the planes, and it appeared to work. It was pretty cool. Oh, I forgot to add, I didn't quite trust my eyes when playtesting, so added a debug.log to see if the on-collision enter was actually working as planned. and it was quite helpful in the beginning, in case my particle effect was not being triggered. The final step was to destroy the original milk bottle and replace it with a broken glass version. This was pretty simple, just required creating another game object variable called broken bottle, and adding another instantiate function. No matter what I did with the script, it still didn't seem to work. I then figured out that I had been assigning the objects incorrectly. I needed to create prefabs of the milk bottles and assign the prefab models, not the original object itself. And it seemed to work. I was pretty happy with the result, and I hope you are too. I learned a huge amount just trying to do this apparently small thing. And if you like this update, go ahead and press that like button, and if you want to follow along my game dev journey, go ahead and press that subscribe button. See you next time.